below 80, now almost below 70. This is looking so good right now for Revival. Of course, behind this, he does have 56 drones to the 43 probes of Noticimus, and it looks like he's going to be going for his counterattack right now. I don't see a very easy way for Noticimus to be able to get out of this. Pylon's getting killed here in the middle of the map, and the counterattack is going to be so, so strong right now from Revival.
That's right. What Noticimus really needs to do at this point is go up to 12 gateways, and then he'll be fine.
Yeah, just get the perfect number that you need to not be able to saturate. It's fine, don't worry about that.
So, unfortunately, guys, this counterattack is looking pretty darn good, and wow, that's a decent number of beach balls being chucked down there from Revival, and why the hell not? Infestor is doing an incredible DPS. He can't really kite back because his buildings are here. The Zealot's going to have to do all the damage against those Infested Terrans, and will the wall get broken? There we go, the first breach in the wall. The pylon does go down. The forge is so close to going out. He needs to target that down. There we go.
Oh, stream
in. No, excellent forcing from the system is keeping him out, but the aggression is really starting to pile up here on the Tissimus. Look at all of the upgrades in the production tab for TSL Revival. He's going to try and turn the screw here. We do have a little bit of a counter attempt with some Zealots up here near the third base. Does Noticimus actually know that third base exists? He does not. So that was great great timing there from Revival, actually stopping Noticimus even getting a scout off, let alone any sort of counter aggression. And I think Noticimus now is in an awful lot of trouble.
Yeah, he is going to be getting, I guess, a 10th gateway on 2 base. So he's going to be moving out with the absolute maximum number of things that he possibly could. This is his all-in at this point. Well, 8 is the number that you can, like, eight gates you can supply. 10 gates, this is an all-in. There's nothing you can do behind a 10 gate.
The 4 gate was kind of an all-in. The 8 gate was definitely an all-in. Now we have a 10 gate, guys. So we're just going to keep upping the number. All right, here comes the 26 gate timing from Noticimus. I don't know what's going to happen. Oh, no, I know exactly what's going to happen.
Oh.
Look at that fungal.
Oh, great force fields there. But those fungals still hitting a lot of those zealots right now. Noticimus is going to be finishing that forward pylon. Our TSL Revival on 4 base versus the 2. Of course, Noticimus can't afford to make anything else. Lots of zealots here. Force fields going down, as well as a lot of great fungals. Infested Terran popping out the back right now. The Infested Terran doing so much to those stalkers. Oh, and GG. I'm just waiting for it, really.
I am. Noticimus going to be able to take this. If Noticimus had initially seen where the third base was from TSL Revival, he would have been able to go around the back and maybe attempt to snipe it off. But at the fact of the matter is he doesn't even know it's there at the moment, and just Ling streaming in are going to be enough to take out most of these units. All of the stalkers now go down. It's only sentries left. And you know what's bad against Zealots? Well, what's good, rather, against Zealots? Those fungal growths just completely demolishing everything else Noticimus had to offer. The supplies are now 131 to 58.
Yeah, I really love that play by Noticimus, dropping some changelings to make... Revival, making Noticimus think he maybe had more Zealots in that army than he really did. So he warped in even more, and it's being taken out. Noticimus just refusing to GG right here. He must know he's behind at this point. And, you know, there's a lot of death happening. Alright, here come the Infested Terran. There's the GG.
I can't deal with beach balls, that's it. Everything else was fine, but as soon as I saw the beach balls, whoa, man, calm yourself. Not gonna touch that stuff. So it looks like Noticimus, unfortunately, gonna be going 0-1 down, but Revival playing very patiently, it has to be said. I mean, he was ahead for so much of that game, but he wasn't trying to go in for all sort of massive kill blow or anything like that. He just kept defending, kept mackering, got his third base up, hit it from Noticimus really well, and just slowly, slowly edged his way towards the victory. There was nothing Noticimus could do. Revival just playing that supremely in game number one.
That's right, guys. You guys are watching the GGA Cup number 4, casted by the ever-so-handsome Jarasar and myself. Nostalgia Talix will be back after this 30-second commercial. I keep messing it up. Is it Jarasar or Jarasar?
Jarasar.
Okay. I keep saying Jarasar, I think.
You may want to... You normally want to leave 5 seconds between saying we're going to a commercial and actually clicking the commercial button.
Yeah, that's right.
I actually normally leave between 10 and 15, but that's because I just like play 2 or 3 commercials and have music running, so I can kind of get away with it.
You. That's right. I don't have commercials on my stream, so I'm still getting used to them.
Sure. It's a lot of fun. Spam them! Because it means we might get minimum wage. No. No chance.
Welcome back, guys. That's right, we don't get minimum wage. We're slave labor here, but it's still worth it. It's one of those,
pretty
like,
much.
It's like, how do I say that? It's like, I don't even know how to say that. But we are back, guys, we're going to be getting
into
the game.
We're passionate! That's what it is. We're passionate!
That's exactly what we are, guys. We're going to be getting into game number two here between TSL Revival and Noticimus. It's going to be on GSL's Antigua Shipyard. That was the Protoss choice.
It's going to be pretty good, man.
All right, it looks like Noticimus is ready to go. So is TSL's Revival. Be getting into this game as soon as it's left from... We need to get in there. All right, here we go. The game is going to be starting. GSL's Antigua Shipyard here between TSL Revival and Noticimus. Game two of the semifinals of today's GGA Cup.
All right, guys, we have spawned on GSL Antigua Shipyard. GGHF, GL, up, open brackets three. Pretty standard now. We're used to seeing in quite a lot of our matchups, and that's because this Protoss boss over here on the left-hand side of the map, spawning in the yellow colors, has been stomping through this tournament, taking out a lot of high-profile players, doing very, very well for himself, but he is down 0-1 in this... in the semi-final, so he really needs to pull one back here to have any chance of progressing to the final. Let's wait and see if he can do that. From Gamers League in Norway, ladies and gentlemen, it is Noticimus. And his opponent spawning in the right-hand side as the pink Zerg player, representing Team SCV Life in Korea, doing an absolutely incredible job so far in this tournament. Will he be able to make it to the finals, though? We'll find out in just a moment. If he can close the series out 2-0, it's going to be Revival.
That's right. We're going to be playing on GSL's Antigua Shipyard. Force crossbomb positions. Noticimus obviously knowing this as he is sending his probe over to the Zerg's base here in the top right-hand corner. Behind this, of course, he is... Got that pylon down. Looks like he's going to be going for a fast forge expand, but it really depends on how many probes he has lined up. It looks like he has quite a few. It looks like it's going to be a Nexus first build here out of Noticimus instead of the forge.
Wow. So, going to try and gamble a little bit, playing particularly greedy against someone who's known for being able to do aggression when he wants to. I can't help but think that as soon as the Overlord spots the Nexus went down first, TSL Revival might go, well, you know what? I have an idea here. And the Baneling Nest might end up going down. He needs to take a gas, though, if he wants this to happen at any point.